I rang the bell. Now he's going to open up the side door and say, "Hey, Mike, come to the side door." So I'm going to be proactive. Let's go to the side door. Yeah. Where are you going? What'd you get rid of the red carpet for? Huh? What'd you get rid of the red carpet? Now I'm gonna start driving crazy by ringing the side door too. It's a big dog. It's got like a big man bark.
Have you ever got bitten by a customer's dog?
Nope. Yeah, no. Well, the other Mike has. See, now this is just rude.
Yeah, like.
You know we're on the way. You made an appointment. And now we're sitting here in third degree weather. I think I'm going to give him the FU price. Make me wait in the cold.
Somehow turn this into an emergency
service. Now we go back to the front door. Right? Knock on the door again. Anyone home? Maybe he doesn't hear the doorbell ring after over the dog barking so much. That's messed up. Side door? Oh man. But you got me here in the cold. You know it's cold out, right?
Okay. You see, a lot of water coming on this valve.
Right here.
That water. Like this morning when I got up, I had it empty yesterday.
And your expansion tank is full.
It's
Yeah, you got about 30 psi of pressure in the boiler. Well, we should probably replace the expansion tank. Get some WD-40 and lube that up. And probably a good idea to replace the relief valve, too. So how long has it been dripping for?
A couple of days.
All right, well, we'll start with the expansion tank. And if the relief valve continues to drip, we should replace that. But you're probably better off replacing that, too. We're gonna take out this Extrol 15. We're gonna install an Extrol number 30. Don't really need a 30 here, but figured this lasted 7 years. We installed this boiler 7 years ago. Figured that maybe an Extrol number 30 will last maybe 15. Who knows? See, and that's the way to wrap Teflon tape around threads. Let me just, it should be all right. Hit it. Lefty loosey, righty tighty. What are you doing?
I was going. I was going the right way.
No, you weren't. You were going the other way. If we have piping in the truck, we're going to make a new drip leg. With the male adapter, a Street 90. The male adapter, a Street 90, and a piece of 3/4 inch pipe. Mongo bit, nice new watts, 30 PSI relief valve. Let's close that. Let's tighten that up. All right, you need a 3/4 inch male adapter, 3/4 inch Street 90, and some approximate small piece of 3/4 inch pipe, and the 3/4 inch press jaw on the press machine. All right, the boiler feed valve is open. No air vent, got all the air out. That really wasn't that expected. Fire up. Good to the last drop. It's only a relief valve, so I'm not too worried. The battery's dead. It really is dead. Hold on, hold on. One more. No, it's dead. Yeah, we need a new M12 battery. What? Oh, come on. This is gonna suck. This is really gonna suck. All right, we need to get a different battery because I don't know if this is good or bad. Hopefully it works. God damn.
No.
No. See, it's like stuck in a mid cycle. There we go. Damn. Uncut, unedited, raw. Now, we installed this boiler in 2018. And since then, tune-up after tune-up after tune-up. And that speaks volumes of the quality of the material that we installed. No major repairs since 2017. Now, granted, in 2024, we had a problem with the first floor where the contractor decided to cap off the 3/4 inch line in the bathroom, removing the baseboard convector that was there. But other than that, see, new bathroom. This is where the contractor stole your ladder, remember? Didn't the contractor steal your ladder? Yeah, right?
Yeah.
The contractor stole your ladder. We did your bathroom.
You want to know something?
Yeah.
You see, that's why, you see, when you give them Spanish guys, you got to be able to watch them guys.
Yeah.
Like that guy.
Who stole your ladder?
Yeah, you see that guy?
Which guy?
the guy who stole the car.
Yeah.
Right? See them guys and them are all scared because I don't know if they got papers or not. You understand?
I hear you.
And you got four children, right? Four children. So when they get an opportunity, you know what I mean?
You got to survive. And then, but you know, it's like, I get it, you know, do what you got to do to support your family. But go after, like, you know, don't go after, like, the citizen. Go after, like, the big banks, the mega corporations that, you know, they piss away millions of dollars a day, right? And it doesn't make a difference to them. I'm not saying it's right, but don't steal from, you know, the hardworking people that are putting food in your mouth. You know, it's just not right. All right, I'm going to take my thermal imaging camera, and we're going to do a scan, make sure everything's heating up properly. There's the boiler.
So that thing is not going to leak now, right?
Nope.
But eventually, would that?
Yeah, in about 15 years from now, or, you know, so, but.